children's stories. Eliezer Bagezer.
Didn't you, Moshem, say all my name, tricky, and say, Nisim? למשל אסתר, חרבון, המרדכי, ויש לו גם את הירידים. ובכל סיפור יש לו שליחים, אבל הוא עושה את העיקר.
So
it's about someone that has like a problem with his law. So he couldn't read right like till he was like 15. And then they went somewhere.
Like Haman?
Ah. Like Darth Vader.
But he has a lot of feelings and he's happy. So the way it's with Kashat, the point that also if you're not different stuff you want to be, and also if you get dressed up, you still have to remember that no matter what you are, you can always be happy when a boy, because you want to compare to my toy.
What?
Nothing. You can always be happy with who you are.
Oh.
Because that seed dropped, a worm got hit. Because he got hit, that worm got mad. Because he got mad, he kicked a tree. A helicopter came and saved them, and they came into town. And that you'll never forget. And as far as I know, it's just conclude with we don't know what's going to happen.
That's because you keep interrupting.
Eva Shlomo, but we want you to have fun this, you know.
I'm having fun, thank you.
You have more to watch.
Anyways, I'm just going to conclude. We don't know what's going to happen in the future. Watch. And when we look back, we see that there is a cause and effect. But we can change it, and we can intervene, and we can, Bezrat Hashem, bring Mashiach down.
Amen.
You didn't talk about...
But you
told me.
That's the Tashlimi, Tashlimi.
I don't know how to lay. I can't lay in here. It's not the woman's meeting.
That's okay. We're in a fraud. We're open minded.
Everybody starts out with equal opportunity. Everybody gets a balloon.
Okay, very socialistic.
But everybody loses their balloon in the end, which is part of why it's kind of depressing. Anyway, Ron gets a yellow balloon.
And he asks,
So Ron was
greedy. He wanted a really big balloon. So what happened to the end?
It popped. You don't deal out with these Israeli books. They have to depress you in order to teach you the positive lesson.
So let's say
they tell you all the bad things to contrast it. Very similar, by the way, to the Megillah.
I'm beginning to all excited about the trip. They're reading the
book. You have to know, Fred, one of them is tall, one is short.
One of them is tall, one is short. And then, as they go more into the woods, one starts having a very hard time, and one everything just seems to go for.
Mr. Derlo.
Nachon, akol olechara. And then at night, Ted's asleep, Fred's awake, and he feels very lonely. It's dark, he doesn't know what's going on. But, and this is actually Noam's favorite page, because there's an owl watching from above. Fred, he actually looks up and he sees nothing. Lo ret yad yisrael, just like in the Megillah. But Ted,
because it's yad yisrael.
It's yad yisrael, he doesn't see, but in a minute we're going to see. From Mishamayim, be'emet magi ha'atzala.
Revach va'atzala yamod
ha'yudim. Right, and then, em asu gam ma'amatz, itbalulu, as they looked up, and the whole time the owl was still guarding them, and everything worked out. And then they ate.
And then they ate, which is very similar to us.
So, in Eliezer and Gezer, they have a problem, but they really want this Gezer that's stuck in the ground, but they can't get it out. So, what they do is first, the little girl tries to take it out, and you know, first the Eliezer, and then the Safta, and then the little girl.
Where's the Safta?
And then the whole, I'm the Safta. And then the whole,
Chamula.
The whole Chamula comes out, including the animals. And the message of the story is that if you work together, you can achieve things that you can never have imagined.
In the household.
You think you can do things alone, and you think you're going to fail and give up. But really, if you're willing to ask for help, especially from people in your family, and you work together as a team, then you can get things out. So, and also, and also, sometimes, in the Megillah, we see the difference between Vashti and Esther. Vashti said, I don't like what the king says, so I'm going to decide on my own. And everybody knows.
Everybody knows.
That if Vashti would have asked her advisors, do you think it's a good idea to refuse the king or not? They probably would have given him an advice, don't do it, it's not smart. But she said, I can manage on my own, and it was her downfall. But Esther, no matter what she does, she always asks Mordechai and has mitya'etzer with other people. And so success is not how much you can do on your own, but how much you can work together.
So when you get dressed up in Purim, so you like pretend to be somebody else. Also when you laugh, so there's a few people that also pretended to be somebody else. Like Haman, so in front of the village, he pretended to be okay. And like...
pretended to be an okay guy.
Yeah. But really, he was like really mean, and he was totally the demon. And the Tamba Teres, so they pretended to be
the guards of the king.
Yeah, that's okay, guys. But really, they wanted to kill Esther. So she pretended to be like she didn't say that she's a Jew.
אז יש לנו מדליה. ויש ארבע מצוות בפורים. משתה, נקרא מגילה. מתנות לאביונים ומשלוח מן. וגם נשים, גם תינוקות היו בנס. אז גם הם יכולים, להתחפש, לתת מתנות לאביונים. אפילו...
מדוע אני כבר משלח מנת שלו?